Welcome, guys. You're here with Snowman 86, and you join me on a new map called Seneca County. So this is a by 4 map as well. If you watch episode 3 of Madison Farms, you will see that towards the end of that episode I speak about this map, and that how we have it set up. So this is the main farm we are in. So if anybody else has played this map, you will know that this farm is slightly different layout to what you see here in front of you. And what we'll do here quickly is just pop into the landscaper mode and give you a quick overshot of the farm. So as you can see, we have cattle. We've added this shed over here for our gear. We have our silo here and a bit of landscaping done around it just to smooth it out. A small lean-to here which houses our two cedars, although this cedar here might have to be swapped out as there is a collision issue when it's folded up. It doesn't recognize it. I'm just going to shoot over here to the back side of the farm. You will see that we've added this garage here as well, and this garage also has the function to act as the workshop. And you will see we have the straw and hay barn here as well. And last but not least, then, in these two areas, if I can get in here and zoom in a small bit, we have our diesel fuel and we have our def tank. We are playing with the def mod. Now the gear we're using is a little bit older, so I will now pop to my garage. Sorry, I was there. So what we have, 7810, a nice 4850. We then have a Peterbilt, the smaller version of the John Deere combine, a smaller tipper, smaller header. We have our chisel plow. We also have our cultivator, although again we might change this out, we'll see how it plays out. We have a small 6 meter cedar for doing our cereal crops for the likes of straw and stuff. We have our row crops sprayer. We have our solid fertilizer spreader, Dispine, a tedder, a rake, forage harvester, and a water tanker. That is all we have. You start the map with this, and as I say, I've taken all the other silos out of this map just so it's for, so it doesn't bias what we can store, as you can see here, which is 480,000 liters. We are playing on economically hard, and again, if I kick back out here once more, you will see, you should see, it won't work now. There we go. We have our times. Look at the ground here. You will see we have everything set to kind of 24 hours as it's currently 4 o'clock in the game. So you can see time has passed. Weeds are due to be an issue shortly, and cotton is due to turn shortly. So you will see that is everything we have. And fields wise, let me zoom in here. Fields wise, we're starting out over here, guys. So we have 33, 34, and 32. 32 is our grass field. And as I say, we start with animals already. So here we are. As you can see, instantly we have a shortage of food. So if my grass doesn't cure enough in time, what will have to happen is we'll have to buy in silage. So we want to try and avoid that. And to avoid it, the best way I can see doing it is this land here for 154,000. It is already in grass, as you see, and it's ready to harvest. So that's what we're looking at here, guys. So let me just get back out of, sorry. So that's where we are. If I turn off grass here now again and just see, I also have course play working on this map, guys. So we are going to test it out here on field 34. I believe that needs to be plowed. Yes, it does. And we'll possibly have to do 31 ourselves. But again, I might make a time lapse, or I might just do it off video. We'll see how it goes. Field 33 is ready. Hopefully the weeds don't affect it too much. So I think first and foremost we're going to get away here at 34. I'm just going to go find our plow, which I believe is in here. There she is. Now you will notice the gear we're using, guys, as I say, it's all small. So our biggest tractor is the 4850 at 192 horsepower, and the 7810 has 175. So the plow requires 120. So we might put the 4850 to work here. Actually, we'll use the 7810, as the 4850 is also our tractor for spraying. So as you will know, we're gonna go for our plow. Now before we do this, I better check the state of the field, because I could get a lash of fertilizer out there. Does it need lime? No, it doesn't. Just 32 and 31 need lime. So we might get one round of fertilizer on this. I think that's what we'll do, and then we will set up the plow. Oh, you'll see I was out spraying recently. Should be able to fit this bad boy in here. Trick now is to get back out without doing any wreck. And we're out. So why am I reversing to this corner, guys? I did not show you, but I will jump out here now quickly and show you. We have our seeds on this side, we have liquid fertilizer on this side, and we have herbicide on that side. What we don't currently have is lime. Or solid fertilizer. So let me just change that there now. Go in here, placeables. Seeds, fertilizer. So the question is, where do we want our fertilizer? It needs to be somewhere convenient, it doesn't interfere with things. I wonder, does outside this shed work? I think it might. If I do that. So we now have our fertilizer trigger over here. So we're backing over there. Hopefully my reversing skills are not as bad as what they might look. I'm gonna turn it a little bit. Right. Open the cover. Not get the trigger there. Might we need to be on the other side? Let me just back it around the corner here. And just pull up using the other side of it. There we go, guys. I hit the trigger. So we're going for fertilizer. And we're going to push about 2,000 liters into this thing. Hopefully that will be enough. Now, you'll also see I'm running the variable spray mod. And the gist of that mod is now that I can turn it down to, we want to go about 100 and go 100 liters an acre. So, I'm just going to pop outside the cab here in a second, guys. Sorry for the noise. Okay, we're going to set off on 2. There, guys. Just gonna turn around here and do the headland. So what I might do at this current point, guys, is I think we will, oh, there's a ditch there, oh my poor tractor. I think we will set up time lapse here on this one. We might try and do this series just a little bit more quicker pace, even though it's using older gear, but I'm sure you don't want to see me going across the field at 8 meters time. So I'll catch you in a bit, guys. geese that takes care of the field. So now what we might do is get our 40-50 over here to plow. The 7810 here, as we might go across the way in a minute with a bit of lime. No, we're gonna have to go find lime first. I don't know if there are lime sometimes on this map. Oh, turn off our GPS. We're gonna use course bay here for this one. This tractor should be able to do this, as it has front wheel assist as well. What we will do temporarily is diff lock it up. Now I'm going to unfold this. So we're going to field work here, guys. We will generate a course first. Looking for the 34 headlines. We're going to give it 3 headlines counterclockwise, start walking on up and down roads. We're going to go turn. There's no island, we don't need that. We're going to do the second direction automatic. Walking with you, saying 7, but I'm sure. It's 8. I'll just go back here now and quickly check this. Ace. So we're going to start it on ace. We'll go 7.5. We're going to go back. I'm just going to reverse here a little bit, get the guy started. We should do this, we want to start on the first waypoint. Stop at last, active. Check here, main offset. Oh, looks good. Okay, we're good to go. We're going to drive course. We're going to see if this guy knows it good at his base. Okay. So it's going to take an hour roughly for course play to complete this. So while course play is doing that, we're going to jump out and have to run by the plow. So we're going to make our way back down here now. And we're going to empty our fertilizer spreader and see how we do for lime. Can we unload? We can. So we've unloaded there. Two Two bags. We can lift these. These aren't too bad. Just gonna lay them here for the temporary measure out of the way. Right, you guys, we're gonna need to go find some lime. Okay, let me quickly pull up the map. Container barn. I am not seeing lime here. I don't know if I got a trigger here. Oh, we have no lime trigger. Must look into one of those. So for the short term, guys, what we are going to do, I'm going to buy a bag of lime. What's the capacity of our team? Our capacity is 8,200 liters, so we will get enough to fill that. Big bags. So what's going to happen here now? We're not going driving all the way to the farm, so we're going to go farm to shop, low course. Drive course. While that's going on, we're gonna go back here and keep an eye on our guy in the field. We're gonna jump in with him here when he comes back down on this pass. We'll just see what he's doing. Just a little bit there. Now, any of you who are used to course play will understand that it does miss bits here and there. It is not a 100% field complete job. But we might stop them on the headlands and we might do it ourselves. Trying to get a little screenshot here now. And when he stops here, we're going to jump in if he stops. Okay, he's not going to stop here, he's going to clean in here. I think 7 meters might have been a more accurate course for this, but we will let this finish out and see how it turns out. He isn't doing a bad job at the moment. Missing a few bits here and there, but I wonder is there anything I can change to turn myself over from this. Circle, maybe. decrease the turning circle, I think. I might just slow him down a fraction on the turns as well. The 10 isn't bad. Maybe for a 6 meter turn. See how this pans out now. Turning a lot tighter. That might be a better job, I think. Okay, I'm gonna leave him at it. Locate our track from here. Why is he driving at 25 miles an hour? Take over here. Turns out course plate. Hold the course. We take over here, guys, and we just pop up here and get the line. And we should get back for a field. 31. Cleaning it on the shop. So guys, this is a new map, as I say. We're going to start a little bit slower and build our way up to the bigger gear, like the 9RTs and the 9RXs. So as you see, I have the economy set on hard. I'll show you the prices there in a minute. Up here alongside the line. So while we're doing this, I'm just going to quickly show you the prices, guys. So we have two sell points, the Legacy and the St. Stephen's auction. And again, you can see the prices here are mid-range. It's going to be a fair graft here to build ourselves up. Cotton is worth a nice bit of money, but it costs a nice bit of money to get into unless we lease the harvester. Silage isn't too bad, but again, we're not ready for silage yet. We first need to take care of our animals. As you'll see, we currently have zero in stock when it comes to grass and silage. We have zero hay, but we do have 166,000 liters of straw. So that's enough to keep the cows bedded for the winter. Do have contracts as well on this map, so it is a handy way of earning a few extra pound, and we will be taking advantage of it, I'd say. And as I say, our cows information here, productivity isn't bad. If we can get the total mixed ration, which we are a bit away from, but between the silage and the grass, I'm hoping to keep them going. So you see, course play here is working away. We are currently all the way up here at the shop. And we have filled up on lime. So what I might just do here, guys, is I won't bore you with the long drive back. Unless you want to see it. We might actually see a bit of the scene. We might go third person here. And you will see some of the scenery as we drive around in the creek there. There's one of the cell points in the background, that's the Legacy. And the 7810 is feeding this with the weight. Small bit of a forest there. There's a times 4 map. Now this is not finished. I believe there's most of the outsides of it, but they are playable to a degree, but you have no field of definitions, no missions, nothing like that. And I actually don't think you can buy them actually, can you? Hang on, let's just check that out there. No, it is not playable, I take that back. So you were talking maybe a good 2/3 of the map is done. So it's enough here to get our teeth stuck into. And hopefully when the final version of the map comes out, we might have to start a new save, as things will probably change, but we will try and keep it all original anyway as we go here, or to the best of my abilities. Sorry there guys, just clearing my throat. See, as we come across here, nice rolling fields, nice landscape, and the distance is again quite well done. Coming up under the creek here, another small yard over there. Timmy can rip into roar there, she hits the hill. That's a nice feature, the clock is actually in zone with the game clock. Does it change? Down the road. Of course it can't change, I just seen something there guys. When I was setting up the map, I'm gonna jump out here. Times 2, and we are away again. Let's see if this clock changes. It does, that's a nice feature. We are coming into the new township, I think. Here on the right, just a little yard, that's nice. Another yard here, actually I think this is the yard we might start the game at. And here it is. the tour person here now again, just as we come through the town, just to give you an appreciation of what we have. Is the church, I believe, town hall, maybe church. Power station here on the right, followed up by houses. A nifty little junction here to make. An old road runs up the side of our farm there. On this side you have your wood chips, straw sails, and the sail point there. And I overshot my turn, so I'll just slide off the road here, guys. I would like to show you this one more feature here. I couldn't find an access point unless you went around here, so what we did was just create a little land bridge here that we can drive down and up the other side. We've added that. And just set ourselves up here. Activate. Oh, we're spreading light. And we seem to be spreading light. So again, guys, I might leave you here at this point, and I continue this off screen again, not before any of you, and when we come back, we'll hopefully have this land and the four plows. As always, guys, it's been a pleasure. If you have any comments or likes or anything like that, please leave them below, and don't forget that subscribe button, you can enjoy what you watch. I've been Snowman86, I'll catch you again, guys.